We have to make sure that, as Mr. Liang Ying Hua says, that we never cross the red line of failing to balance our budget within each term of government. And Mr. Hri Kumar also spoke on this matter. Ensure sustainability, ensure we never run down our reserves. This is why, in fact, we have written rules into our constitution. We've gone further than most other countries. By writing the rules into the constitution to prevent a government from running a deficit within its term of government, a cumulative deficit. Except in crisis, you have to go to the president and to get his permission to draw on reserves. We've written it into the constitution so that it's enshrined as part of our political culture, no matter who's in government. Mr. Hri Kumar and Mr. Arthur Fong also voiced concerns about the budget deficits that we are running in recent years. So let me just clarify that the government budget has been in a healthy position. For this year, as I've explained, the deficit is almost entirely due to funds being set aside for future investments. It's not a deficit of spending over revenues. It's a deficit because we are setting aside funds that we've earned in this term of government for the future. And until this year, during this term of government, we have not recorded a deficit in any year before setting aside funds for the future. For example, the small deficit we ran last year would have been actually a significant surplus had we not set aside money for the Pioneer Generation Package. So essentially what we've been doing is prudent budgeting. We've had a temporary surplus in revenues, particularly because of the revenue boost from the property cycle. And rather than spend those revenues in the current term, which is what some other governments do when they've got a bonanza in revenues, spend it, we have set it aside. And that should remain the way we go about fiscal planning in the future. When you have a temporary boost of revenues and you know the cyclical reasons why your revenues exceed your spending, set it aside for the future. Don't spend it immediately, or don't spend all of it immediately. That way we avoid feast and famine in our spending.